Welcome to Let's Play Forza Motorsport 3, Part 203. Yes, this is the Peugeot, not the Acura. This race is awful, so I'm using the fucking Peugeot. That's all I have to say. I don't give a fuck. I've been trying and failing for over an hour now, so I'm just... fuck it. No, they just have traction control. Respond to that drifting comment, which is incorrect. Really, really do. Is on one of the GT4 challenges. I think it was like One Lap Magic. Like the first set of One Lap Magic challenges. Or missions, excuse me. Wow, that could not have been worse. This is really annoying that I actually am trailing Rossi. Really, really fucking annoying. Because once I inevitably make my stupid mistake, I can't block him. Jesus, how did I get a 36? I mean, I know a lot of that has to do with slipstream. Jesus. It's 3 a.m. I've been going at this race for over 2 hours, well, around 2 hours now. No, over 2 hours. Oh yeah, I know. My lap times got very, very bad once I switched to in-car cam. It's because I couldn't fucking see where I was going. I had to do it for the aesthetic of the video, but... Fuck that, I'm not doing it this time. I am tired of this fucking race, I just want to get it done. Okay, 36.7 without slipstreaming, holy damn. Please let me keep this pace up. Winning and keeping my I've never had sanity. What am I talking about? Definitely more important than aesthetic. God, that drift trial in GT6. Remember how the drifting became like 10 million times easier once I switched from a wheel to the controller? That's just absolute fluke. I got the Route 5 one. Route 5 was a fluke, nothing more. Route 5 5 took no time. It's like, all right, well, another drift trial, time to be here for 2 hours, and then within like 15 minutes, I get it. Like, oh, excuse me. That's not correct. I swear it gave me like 3,000 pity points. Yeah, low to the 37s, the high 36s are perfect. Because Rossi goes around the 37.4 range. Yeah, 37.4. View because I can't be asked to fucking go with the interior view. Plus 420, anyways. Means. I know Rossi's there. I'm not gonna. Not a thing, so fucking I don't even know. Fast out is definitely a good way to go. That's what I try to do all the time, even though I, for some reason, can't. Or at least don't do it well enough. Fast out. That's how you do the quickly. Fast and grass eat my ass. Oh my god. When you fuck your girlfriend, then you're about to nut. God damn it. But what if she likes it fast in and out and in and out and in and out? Hmm. did I go to second gear? I don't need second gear. I slowed down a fuck ton. For that turn when I didn't need to. One more goddamn pissing lap. Yeah, Moore, we fucking left Moore, so I don't have to worry about him this time. Because, you know, I didn't Hamilton this field this time. I've actually been able to see for the second half of the race. Fucking wheel spin. Now, Hamilton tactics weren't exactly wrong, they were just a very dick move. They were a huge dick move. Okay. Fuck this race. Fuck this race. That should not have taken me anywhere close to 2 hours. Fuck, that's all I really have to say. Just fuck. Ugh, man. Beat P2 cars by half a minute. Oh yes, dick move would also be brake checking Rosberg, but still. It was a dick move in the form of he was defying team orders. So, you know. Plus he was being really unclassy, motherfucker. You know, once the cameras were off, well, once he got out of Parc Fermé and the poet, shut up, me. Point is, I won this race. Finally. Hopefully. Ugh, God, that was awful. Just so, so awful. Oh, yeah, I guess I should point out, like I said, one thing that helped ensure victory, maximum downforce. Okay. We finally got that out of the way, so next time on Forza fucking 3, we're gonna go to the R3 World Tour and hope for, less terribleness, so stay tuned for that.